Well, we're on the grounds of Fort McHenry National Historic Monument. Doing a quick pan around. These big cannon here look a little too modern to be, I think, part of the 1814 battle. Be interested to find out where they came from and et cetera, et cetera here, but we're on the grounds. Also, we're looking over Baltimore Harbor here. Every so often, you'll hear a great big growly sound. They're loading a lot of ballast and gravel over there in the ships and so forth. But anyway, hey, if you could visualize the night in September 1814. Rockets, red glare, bombs bursting in air. British fleet was out there. They were far enough away that the cannons that were being used here, as I was reading from the water battery, they would shoot out maybe a mile and a half or so, and the British more or less stayed out of range of the shore batteries here, and of course their fire coming in this way was rather ineffective. Probably a lot of it landed in the water, wherever the water line was. Of course, 1814, almost 200 years ago. This being February 2013, we're getting close to our 200th anniversary. Earlier I got some video of the visit to the center and all that, so you can get some good information. We'll go inside and visit the buildings, but I don't think that's the original flagpole, 200 years old, but anyway, this is the grounds where that huge flag, I was reading, it's 30 by 42 feet, cost a little under $600 in 1814 money. That was a lot. Anyway, saw the flag just last week in D.C. at the National Museum of American History. I think it's a formal title. I call it the History Museum. It's on the Mall. I got some video of that. Can't take any pictures of the flag itself. They don't allow any photography and so forth. It's all been faithfully preserved and all. I spent quite a bit of time making the flag look a lot better. It's been damaged over the years because there were a lot of souvenirs. Major Armstead, his family held the flag after the battle for many, many, many years, and during that time souvenirs were taken of it, and so it got chopped up and shrunk quite a bit before it was finally given to the Smithsonian back in the early 20th century, around 19 whatever. Okay, into the fort. It's cold out here.